To some, dreams are fantasies. To others, they are the roots that drive a man to succeed. A soul truck purchased in 1974 would be that vehicle to pursue this dream. Over time, this loan truck would grow, realizing that the man's dream has far reached his expectations. More than just a delivery company, more than just one truck. This is a journey that was started with little more than the core values we are taught in our lives. On August the 8th, 1952, on a small, honest farm in Saint-Honoré, Quebec, Émile and Blanche Carrier would welcome their son Richard into the world. Amongst his 12 siblings, they lived a happy, hard-working, yet simple daily farm life. This lifestyle would become instrumental later in their lives.
It was a hard life, but a happy life. Everybody was happy. We had really good folks there. Everybody was happy and healthy.
Richard's parents motivated him and gave him the encouragement, along with all of their children, to do something with their lives by working hard and seeing it through to success.
We'll give credit to my father there at 90% there. They give us the trust to on ourselves there to do something, make it right, be proud of what we're doing. I give credit to my father, my mother there at 90%. The other 10 is probably me, but 90% is from them.
Living in such a large family gave Richard and his siblings a unique advantage and a unique bond that would help and encourage each other into doing that special something.
Everybody in the family there, from the sister to all my brother, have all the same mindset, do it something, do it, grow something on life, to achieve something, and they all succeed really well.
He wants to keep expanding. He wants to have the best equipment in the facility in order to do the best quality job, because quality in for him means, that's his that's how he's built his business on. It's all been about quality and service, quality and product, and standing behind his word. His word is worth more than anything else.
By the eighth grade, Richard chose to drop out of school, deciding that he would be able to achieve more through hard labor. At the age of 14, he moved to the States with his brother-in-law, Fernand Gregoire, siding and roofing homes in Bristol, Connecticut. 6 months later, Richard began his journey around the East Coast, working in Maryland, Virginia, Pennsylvania, Vermont, and New Hampshire. On a vacation trip back home, Richard would meet his future wife, Nicole, and at the age of 19, the two were married. In 1973, Richard started his own drywalling business, but in 1974, he decided to follow in the footsteps of his father and move to Jackman, Maine, to start what would become Richard Carrier Trucking. He financed his truck with a trailer for a grand total of $40,350. What followed was a road of long hours and hard work. It was a difficult time for Richard, always working and being away from his family, but he remained headstrong and driven towards the vision. With Nicole at home raising the children, Richard was on the road trying to survive and keep his family safe and happy. The long hours and hard work started to pay off. In 1979, Richard would purchase his second truck. In 1980, a third was added to the now growing fleet. In 1981, he would add another truck and purchase his first piece of equipment, a Barco 160 crank loader, to aid in the loading of logs.
Richard's a pretty interesting character. Yeah, he comes on pretty strong, but he's really got a heart of gold. So he treats everybody with respect and treats everybody fine.
Within only a few years, there was a need for expansion, and in 1987, the company was moved to a more strategic location. Skowhegan, Maine seemed to be a location where most hauling was centralized around the state and would become the new home of Richard Carrier Trucking. Using exclusively Western Star trucks, Richard Carrier Trucking would have a fleet totaling 12 trucks as he moved his business. With the new location, Richard would have a central office to work on it, his own garage, and mechanics to maintain his trucks.
We do our transmissions, rear ends, motors. We don't do in-frame overhauls, but...
From here on out, the company would grow far beyond Richard's initial dream.
The way Richard works? Oh, yeah. I like the way he says it. When he says it's like that, it's going to be like that. It's not a problem. We don't meet too many people like that in their life, you know. So we don't have to talk 2 times about the same problem. When he says, okay, we'll go for it, that's it.
In 1984, Richard was working for Connecticut Shipping, providing them with bark. Working for them was a man, Ross D'Elia, who was a buyer for that company. The owner of Connecticut Shipping would tragically pass away in 1987, and the company was sold off, leaving a gap in Richard's business. The following year, Richard would branch from the trucking industry with an opportunity presented to him by D'Elia.
I approached Richard about buying HHP, which was up for sale. HHP had been established in 1966 as a sawmill and a pallet manufacturing facility.
The purchase of HHP would give Richard the ability to get out of the open market and create his own work for Richard Carrier Trucking. With his new business adventure with D'Elia and the overall growth of his trucking company, Richard found a need for expansion. In 1989, expansion would begin by moving the office away from the maintenance facility, creating its own private location. In 1990, the garage would be expanded on its two bays, adding a grease and wash bay. HHP was only the beginning of Richard's expansion. In 1991, Richard and his brother Jack were given an opportunity to produce wood chips for a paper company called Boise Cascade. With a contract in hand, they built a chip plant and named it RJ Chipping. With the successes of RJ Chipping, Richard and his brother Jack were given another contract to produce more wood chips for Boise Cascade. With the opportunity to produce more for his trucking company and expand his businesses even more, Richard and Jack built another chipping facility in Farmington, Maine, and aptly named it Farmington Chipping.
The plant was established in 1994 with two production lines, a 27-inch ring debacker, Nicholson ring debacker, and 9x60 price drum.
Around the same time, Richard continued to expand Richard Carrier Trucking by installing fuel pumps and building a warehouse to store parts. This way, he would be able to keep overhead costs down by buying necessary parts in bulk. In 1995, Richard and Ross found that the HHP facility wasn't meeting their needs, and they built an entire new facility a short distance from the old one. In doing so, they were able to build a top-of-the-line facility that could keep up with the needs of their clients. The offices of Richard Carrier Trucking would be expanded in 1996 with an area completely devoted to dispatching, allocating 6 new offices and a driver's room. Farmington Shipping was expanded in 1997 to meet the needs of its client, the New Page Corporation.
They added another production line, a 17-inch tandem ring debarker, and a second screen to accommodate for the extra flow of chips on the output end of the plant.
Today, Farmington Shipping is able to produce 40 to 50 truckloads a day, equaling 300,000 tons of chips per year. The growth of operations would also continue the expansion of Richard Carrier Trucking, and in 1997, Richard added 2 trailer bays and a scale to measure loads. By 2001, the yard would be expanded yet again, adding a dumper site and a portable chipper. Richard Carrier Trucking would begin storing round wood, wood chips, and bark for its customers, for when the product is needed, it is delivered. Richard and his brother Jack began purchasing land together so that they could furnish their mills with the raw materials that was needed. Together, they have more than 80,000 acres of woodland, and with it, they have become more self-contained and able to raise the profit and value of their companies as a whole. Richard Carrier Trucking delivers goods all over the United States and Canada. Beginning in the late 90s, security at the American-Canadian border increased, and even more so after 9/11. This was causing a headache for Richard and decreasing productivity. To combat this, Richard decided to purchase a trucking company in Canada. LCC became the newest addition to the Richard Carrier industry and was shortly after followed by TJF. In the late 1990s, LCC was a financially struggling transportation company. Richard found this to be the perfect opportunity to invest in a Canadian trucking company. The business was improved by restructuring LCC to resemble Richard Carrier Trucking, transporting mostly raw forest material. Today, LCC is a profitable transportation company with 40 trucks, its own garage and maintenance facility. A few years after the purchase of LCC, Richard would invest in another struggling Canadian transportation company. With financial issues and inadequate equipment, what would become TJF was in need of some work. To help with the restructuring and managing of the company, Richard called upon a man called Jean Guy.
I own my own truck since many years. You know, when Richard bought the company here, he called me to ask if I want to work together, you know, and try to do something with that business. He says he needs some people to rebuild that company, and I says yes, I can come and try to do something with that. You know.
Jean had a small problem with needing to get rid of his own truck and trailer. Richard had a solution.
When I came for Richard, I got my own truck and my trailer, and I said, Richard, first of all, I have to sell that. And Richard told me, what's the price for that? Telling him a price, and says, okay, coming back, we'll make you a check. I said, Richard, you don't see that equipment, you know. Well, he says, Jean-Guy, if you says it's mean that money, it's mean that money. I don't have to see that, you know. And it's made quick like that. It says, wow.
Today, TJF runs 30 trucks, transporting mostly finished forest products all over Canada and the United States. However, TJF diversifies its business by transporting oversized loads and other products as well. With their drivers on the road up to 20 days at a time, the trucks take constant wear and tear. With their own maintenance facility, TJF is able to keep the trucks in top running condition. Together, the two companies have become a profitable working addition to the Richard Carrier family. At the end of 2006 and early 2007, expansion would begin to explode for Richard. First, the purchase of 2 chip plants, one in Milo, Maine, and the other in Costigan, Maine. For a short time, Richard and his brother Jack became partners in a paper mill. Unfortunately, unlike all of his other investments, this one did not work out, and the brothers pulled out of the investments. In early 2007, Richard and his brother Marco Carrier got into the mulch business with a purchase of P.R. Russell in Richmond, Maine. At the same time, they bought land in Brentwood, New Hampshire, to create an even bigger, more centralized mulch operation under the same name. The acquisition of P.R. Russell would simultaneously increase the value of Richard Carrier Trucking and increase the productivity and value of P.R. Russell. Milan Lumber was another opportunity that Richard and his brother Jack took advantage of in Milan, New Hampshire. Investing in new equipment and the facility, the mill became operational in 2009. Sending grade A lumber all over the world, Milan Lumber is only second to HHP. From the beginnings of one truck, Richard has grown his company into a conglomerate of industries that utilizes each other to run an efficient, profitable business. Richard is a man who has never stopped dreaming. Even though there are no plans to expand his business any further, he still dreams of one day owning his own paper company. Though a lofty goal, Richard is just the man to do it. With a lot of hard work, dedication, motivation, and a dream, Richard has gone from a farm boy to building himself a successful and ever-expanding business. He is very proud of what he has achieved and hopes to one day hand the reins over to his family, ensuring their future and the generations to come.